What's up, Aztec Nation? I'm John Schaefer for GoAztecs.com, and welcome to our version of the 2020 Aztec football season as we look back on some of the more memorable games of the past decade. Today we're going back only a couple of years to 2018. The Aztecs were 1-1 heading into their home game against nationally ranked Arizona State, a team they'd beaten the year before in Tempe. Ryan Agnew was making his first career start because the school's all-time winningest quarterback, Christian Chapman, was injured the week before. State trailed 14-7 in the latter stages of the second quarter, but that's when the Aztec defense came up huge and helped turn the momentum to the guys wearing red and black.
From San Diego, California, we welcome you to an evening of late-night college football, matching the Sun Devils ranked 23 from the Pac-12 against the Aztecs of San Diego State. Rather than bring the kicking unit on, it's 4th-and-1 with the offense staying on the field, so a timeout to think about it. Herm Edwardson's Manny Wilkins in the offense back for 4th-and-1 from the 11.
Hold your water if you're San Diego State. He can't jump off sides.
Wilkins, 4th-and-1, pressured, and he's sacked at the 15-yard line. And San Diego State gets the 4th-down stop. Cheatham gets the sack on Wilkins. So Arizona State drives it from inside their own 5 all the way down to the 16-yard line. But it was that one they could not get. They line up for the offense on 4th-and-1. Take a timeout, run it anyway, and 0 points out of the drive with a minute 41 left. Agnew, play action. Dancing. He wanted the long shot. Now Agnew scrambling out of the pocket. Goes sprinting, shoved out of bounds near the 23. First time they haven't scored in the red zone in 64 trips. You go back to 2016 versus Washington. 64 straight trips. Arizona State football scores in the red zone. Aztecs uncharacteristically moving with some pace to the outside. Incomplete for Trevilian. Sun Devils get a stop on 2nd and 3rd. May use a timeout. Agnew zips it over the middle. That is wearing, stretching, picking up a first down to the 40-yard line.
Keep moving the football, but you got to work the edges around because you only have one timeout. You want to save that for a field goal if you need it.
Agnew to the edge and another misfire. That one intended for Dado.
The goal in this situation is to get positive yards, first downs, and get out of bounds. The last thing you can do, though, is take a sack. This is an Arizona State team that's been able to put the ball up and move it down in big chunks. This is a hugely important third down for the Aztecs.
Haven't converted one yet. Agnew on the roll. Throwback. Washington has the grab at the 45. Has the first down across the 50-yard line. Got it into the hands of Washington earlier. Heavy pressure from the Sun Devils. Agnew zips it complete across the 40-yard line. Got to hurry up now. That's exactly right. Inside the 39. Busby makes the catch.
They're going to go. They call two plays back to back.
2nd and 3. Forget about clocking it. Agnew tossing again, completing again. Now you're in field goal range inside the 25. Clock stops temporarily. Let's see. 22 seconds. They're not going to bring the kicking unit out here. See if they can run one more play. 19 seconds. No timeouts. Agnew to the outside. Inbound. Spinning out. First down inside the 10. 12 seconds. Clock stops temporarily. Wow. So Dado, makes the catch. 12 seconds, and now they're not going to bring the kicking unit out yet.
Well, you take some shots at the end zone. You have probably two plays.
And no timeouts remaining for the Aztecs. So Agnew, 1st and goal, quick hitter. End zone, touchdown! As San Diego State perfectly executes the 2-minute drive. Wilson holds it in. After the Sun Devils went for it on 4th-and-1 in the red zone, the San Diego State defense gets a stop. And a minute 33 later, 11 plays, touchdown, Aztecs, a PAT away from tying it. The Aztecs were thinking end zone the whole time and managed to walk the tight wire.
Well, this is a great job by the tight end holding the safety, DeMonte King, right there, who freezes and flashes and allows Wilson to get just behind him. And Agnew, who's really struggled to throw the football accurately, throws a ball on the dime for the biggest score of the night from the Aztecs, thanks to the 4th-and-1 try that Arizona State had deep in the red zone. The Aztecs make them pay and make them pay big. We got a tie ball game, Cotta.
Aztecs added a pair of field goals in the third quarter to go up by 6 heading into the fourth. That's when the offense started to get on track, thanks in part to a sophomore running back who had to pick up a bulk of the load.
Aztec defense elite.
Rocky Long, one of the innovators of the 3-3-5, coming up big on that 4th-and-1, but it's really been constant pressure, stuffing the run game, giving them nowhere room to run, and then coming up enough through the air. It's really been Rocky Long and his effort tonight with his unit that's playing without its best player, Noble Hall, that's been the story of this game.
Jasmine in the backfield across the 45, across the 50. Jasmine breaks free. Into the secondary for the Sun Devils, takes it to the 30. Jasmine still in there giving Washington a break. Jasmine, right side, another big hole. Jasmine does it again. No penalties down this time as he breaks it across the 45. It's another run of 10-plus. Everything pointing to the Aztecs now with a head of steam. Chase Jasmine shaking his way before Jalen Harvey can finally bring him down, but move the chains again. Have only 9 yards of offense. It is already late for Arizona State. But now in the fourth with the lead in the high red zone, running it. A little end around, Ethan wow. Dado, and he took a pop. On 3rd-and-1 in field goal range, just 2 third-down conversions for the Aztecs until Jasmine picks it up to the 21. It's a first down. You can run more clock, and again, you're in field goal range that would put you up by 9. Touchdown, not going to say it's game over with a touchdown here, but with the way the Aztecs can control the clock and the way the Sun Devils have struggled to do anything in the second half.
But the Sun Devils not being so lucky tonight, they can't get the run game going or the pass game going here in the second half.
Wilkins literally shaking his head on the sideline, watching the defense try to get off the field, give the offense a chance in the last 6:55. But instead, more room. Jasmine shoved out by Frederick. The Sun Devils are having as much trouble now on defense as they are on offense.
No question. It was interesting there. Jasmine was thinking about trying to stay in bounds. He busted outside, but look at the difference in the rush yards in this second half, Carter. That is the story of the game.
Clock doesn't stop yet going out of bounds, so still rolling at 6:29. Jasmine again, right up the middle, gets to the 15. You got third down coming. Rennell Wren makes that stop, but still, even after a gain of nothing on second down, 3rd-and-3, and you are in the red zone. On 3rd-and-3, keep it on the ground. Why not? Haven't thrown it on the drive. Move the pile again. 1st-and-goal, San Diego State. Late flag comes in. Inside of 5 now. They've already used up almost 5 minutes on this drive. Keep it on the ground. Why not? Right up the middle. You get it all back on 1st down. Here comes another flag. Jasmine, the ball carrier, takes it to the 10. 1st and goal. Haven't thrown it on the drive. 11th play is 1st and goal. Snap it with 4 seconds on the play clock. Jasmine pushing ahead. Even after a break for the Arizona State defense, they still can't get a push on 1st down. Snap it with 4 seconds again. Jasmine on the right side, inside the 5. 3rd and goal, but you get to run more clock. Agnew will, of course, hand off. Jasmine pushing, stretching, reaching, touchdown, San Diego State. The Aztecs go up big in the fourth with 4:14 to go. The first touchdown of the second half caps a 13-play drive, eating 6:16 off the clock and forcing the Sun Devils to hope for a miracle now with 4:14.
This is just power football, pulling your backside guard. Lassard with a nice kick out. But how about Chase Jasmine? 5'11", 185 pounds, the second effort to stretch out. And because Lassard is underneath him, none of his body touches the ground, which allows him the time to outstretch his arms and break the plane. When it rains, it pours. When you're this San Diego State offense, just tremendous effort to cap an unbelievable drive.
Aztecs were going for two. San Diego State, more plays on that drive than Arizona State has snapped in the second half.
Wow.
Toss it. That works too. Two more points on the board. Waring holds it in. The two-point conversion is good for San Diego State. And it is a two-touchdown lead with 4 minutes and 14 seconds.
Now you can lease a new 2021 Corolla Hybrid for just $239 a month or get $1,250 factory cash back. We make it easy. Toyota, let's go places.
Sun Devils have to move with the gas pedal down. Manny Wilkins on the roll. Wilkins looking way downfield, zips it underneath. Benjamin out of bounds. 4:02, and the frustration continues for Wilkins. Boy, we have seen that all night, really beginning with the fourth and one in the red zone.
Now, what are you doing? He's yelling and he's cursing out at his players. Man, this team is falling apart right in front of our eyes. Well, we're going to find out how good of a coach Herm Edwards is after this one.
Benjamin, first down. Move the chains. There is the first down of the second half for Arizona State. So all three and outs. That's it. I mean, just incredible. Meanwhile, San Diego State uses 6+ on their last drive. Go up by 2 touchdowns.
For the Aztecs, keep everything inside and in front, applying pressure.
That's a drop.
Now you know Benjamin drops the football. This is just a sign of a young team.
With the clock and 2 touchdowns, San Diego State still advantage. Second and 10, needing something big. Wilkins, check down again. Gain of 7, but this is a recipe tick, tick, that plays right into San Diego State's hands.
Tick, 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 tick. You simply can't nickel and dime your way down the field. You got to take a shot here. You got to convert here on third down, obviously. But the next first down, you got to think about taking an intermediate to a deep ball.
Wilkins, 3rd and 3. There's your deep ball. Intermediate. Harry makes the grab. Woods with him on the catch. It's a first down. Clock stops temporarily, but still don't give up the big play over the top that the Sun Devils are going to need at some point.
Man, has he been quiet tonight. These DBs, they got burned earlier a couple different times for the Aztecs, but they've really kind of locked down here in the second half. I give them a lot of credit for that.
More pressure, 1st and 10, down the seam. There's Harry, got it at the 40. Wrestled down, moving the chains. Thompson on the stop.
I love it. We should have seen more of that. That time he was in the slot. That's what you want. It creates a mismatch. Puts him on a safety. Puts his hand in the ground. You know they're going to be playing off coverage. You might get that a couple more times here on this drive.
2:25, needing 2 touchdowns. Wilkins on the roll. Takes a shot. Incomplete. It was Benjamin on the wheel route out of the backfield against the Mike linebacker Tauzino, but couldn't deliver it.
Now we're going to see Rocky Long dial up that pressure.
Wilkins down the seam again. There's Harry again. Holds it in inside the 30. First down. Clock stops. 2:13. Well, they found a recipe. That one's a 15-yard gain against the soft secondary right now for the Aztecs.
Yep, that time he was lined up one-on-one out on the outside like he is here at the bottom of the screen. He's got that big body and those strong hands. Hit him again.
Benjamin on the outside, dancing his way, knocked out of bounds by Tariq Thompson.
Here they come.
They haven't run it. Wilkins now is going to tuck it, and he is going to run, dancing inside the 10, hurdling inside the 10. First and goal, Arizona State. Wilkins hurdles to pick it up himself. Trenton Thompson forces him out with a minute 44. First and goal.
Man coverage with vertical routes. Everybody turned their back. Manny Wilkins saw the hole, just decides to take off and run. Gets them down inside the 10-yard line. This has been an impressive drive for Arizona State. They've got a chance here to get in this end zone and keep themselves in this game. This is why composure is so important in this moment. Poise is being at your best when it's needed.
10 plays, 75 yards so far. Wilkins fade. Harry, touchdown, Arizona State. The sun has not yet set on the Sun Devils. With a minute 40 to go, Harry into the end zone. So in 2:28, 11 plays, TD, N'Keal Harry.
Beautiful route, and look at the location of the football. Kyrie Woods takes a swipe at it, just mistimes his swipe. Harry again with that great body control, twists his body and comes down to end the most impressive drive of the second half here for the Sun Devils.
Well, Reese is going to have to pull some magic late in this one. The Mickelson brothers, yeah, they're encouraged, but still Arizona State down by a touchdown. Wilkins to Harry. They need one more of those. Not the ball game yet, but they could sure use it. And San Diego State gives them no chance. I mean, that was a line drive recovered by Parker Houston, the tight end. So now the Sun Devils will use those two timeouts. But you have to stop the Aztecs at some point, even with the ability to stop the clock twice.
Yeah, that play didn't have a chance there. So what it brings up is the scenario that you mentioned, Carter. This defense has to be able to get a stop. Joe Moore, the greatest offensive line coach in the history of this sport on this level, said that there's no greater joy than moving a man from point A to point B against his will. The Aztecs are tasked with that here.
Jasmine takes the toss on the left side. He'll be dropped for a loss. There is, let's see where the first timeout comes. Not going to take it here on first down, so don't stop it after first down. They're going to save him for second down and third down.
Interesting there, especially with the loss of yardage there. This makes the play calling and the situation all the more difficult. Herm Edwards going over these scenarios time and time again. I really thought that they would have called a timeout after that first down, because this is going to bleed down to under a minute.
Under a minute to snap it on second down. Presumably use a timeout then on second down. But the clock just running right now in the Aztecs' favor. Jasmine, he's going to slip through across the 35-yard line. The timeout is granted with 51 seconds. So one remaining, and now this is all, it's all third down. I mean, if you don't get a stop here, then San Diego State has won the game.
I don't understand why you don't take a timeout in that situation prior to. They do use it here now. This is a 3rd-and-7 call. To your point, they've got to find a way to get themselves off the field here to burn that last time out, to preserve some time, and then hope that their receivers can go up and try and make some plays against this Aztec defense. And it really seems like on the drive right before this, that passing offense of the Sun Devils got going.
We had a great conversation with Herm Edwards about clock management, late game situations this week, because they did it nearly perfectly against Michigan State. Played keep away when they had the lead. Game was tied, got the game-winning field goal to win it 16-13. But now not using the timeout after first down leaves you very little chance. And obviously, if the Aztecs convert on 3rd-and-7, doesn't matter.
Maybe doesn't want San Diego State to talk about what they were going to run on second down.
Here's the handoff. Jasmine pushing first down. The Aztecs have wrapped it up. As long as Jasmine hangs on to the football, it is loose. The Sun Devils think they have it. The Sun Devils think they have the football, and now a critical call coming. Did it come out late? Did Jasmine lose the football? And if so, who has it? It is Arizona State football with 43 seconds, one timeout, and the miracle that Arizona State needed late. They have the football down by a touchdown. Amazingly, San Diego State fumbles the football. This is Jasmine, and at the end of the run, Robertson reaches in and rips it out.
I don't know. They may need to look at this again. It looked like, to me, his right buttock hit the ground before that ball started coming out.
Jasmine's a sophomore. I mean, if you just go down, this game is over. Just go to the ground, ball game. Instead, he's pushing. It's a 20-yard run. Give credit to the Sun Devils for reaching in. J.J. Wilson and Merlin Robertson both trying to rip it out. But was he down? Game rests on this call. 43 seconds, only one timeout left for Arizona State. San Diego State, if they hang on to the football here, you can take a knee on first down. Arizona State timeout. You snap it on second down,
ball
and the
game.
Game's over.
It's ball game. And spot on, Carter. I'm looking at the call. You made a great point. Go down to the ground. You
right.
Get the first down. It's over.
Right. I mean, at any point in that run, after Jasmine picks up the first down, if he just goes, I mean, that was an additional 12 yards when it did not matter. After you get that first down, you can go down with Arizona State, only one chance to stop the clock more. And again, I mean,
he's a true sophomore. He
right.
hasn't played a whole lot this year. This is a learning opportunity. I think he's going to have a close miss and learn a very important lesson here that's not costly.
Here's the call.
After further review, the ruling of a fumble stands.
Mm-hmm.
First down,
wow.
Arizona State.
Wow. Call stands.
Versus confirmed.
Mm-hmm. So it's a fumble by Jasmine, giving Arizona State a chance. 43 seconds, one timeout.
I don't think they got this right. I disagree with the call. I think he's down there before that ball starts coming out. When you freeze it, he's still clearly got possession. But nonetheless, this Arizona State team is alive.
At the end of the college football day, one last glorious 43 seconds in regulation. Wilkins steps up in the pocket. Wilkins is going to take off. He has the first down and gets out of bounds, stopping the clock with 36 seconds. Well, we gave Herm Edwards a hard time about not taking that timeout after first down, but because of the takeaway by the defense, you have one left here for your last 36 seconds. Clock will start rolling as it's Wilkins got out of bounds. Not going to stop it yet. 36 seconds. Now Wilkins on first and 10. Winds up, zips it outside. That's complete. Darby gets out of bounds, 31 seconds. Moving to the 50 after a gain of 16.
And that was a dime. They've got to continue to keep working these S's. San Diego State only rushes three. They're getting conservative here. In the middle of the field, you don't want to give up a deep shot, so you rush three, you drop eight. But as they get closer to the goal line, you've got to bring some pressure on Wilkins. You can't let him sit back there and throw.
Harry in the slot. Wilkins got to dump it out of bounds, preserving the timeout. 25 seconds left. Aztecs scored 14 straight to take command. And now Arizona State trying to make it 14 straight late. Wilkins winds up, fires incomplete on the edge. Big hit, no flags as Newsom is drilled by Trenton Thompson. Third and 10 with 20 seconds.
That is good safety play coming over and helping out your cornerback. That ball floated up in the air. Newsom just misses the ball and then takes a shot to the solar plexus to boot.
Still with a timeout. Third down. Wilkins zips it down the seam. Harry can't hang on. Fourth and 10 with 14 seconds left. He had Harry on the seam again, couldn't make the connection.
He's lucky this didn't get intercepted. It was very close to being intercepted. He threw that ball into traffic. It was a little bit of a desperation heave. Carter, it's fourth down and we got ball game. San Diego State's going to take a timeout to discuss what they're going to call.
San Diego State, their final timeout of the half. This is a 30-second timeout. 30 seconds.
What a game, man.
Oh, the wackiness at the end of the college football day. 23rd-ranked Arizona State trying to avoid becoming the third-ranked team to lose to an unranked opponent on this college football Saturday. Trailed by two touchdowns with 4:14 to go in the fourth. Used 2:28 to score the touchdown to get them within seven. Then the takeaway from the San Diego State offense when Jasmine just needed to go to the ground. Instead, a takeaway, and there's still a timeout. So fourth and 10, you can convert on fourth and 10 and still have another play left in this game for Arizona State. So it's not all on the line on fourth and 10. You can pick it up and still have a chance to get it in the end zone, but first you got to get at least 10.
San Diego State called that timeout. Rocky Long talking to his team. Don't get beat over your head. Fly to the football. I'm interested to see if he dials up pressure here, but it looks like he's going to stay conservative.
Fourth and 10. Wilkins lines up. He's going to air it all out to the goal line. Darby hauls it in inside the five. Here comes a flag. 6 seconds on the clock in the fourth. Multiple flags. Clock is going to stop temporarily on the moving of the chains, then check the flags. Saw Herm Edwards running out there to call timeout. Just in case anything wacky happens with the clock. They saved the one timeout. And you're going to have a huge stop down here as you check for targeting, assuming that's the call. Darby holds it in first and goal.
The ruling on the field is a completed catch for a first down during the play. Personal foul targeting defense number 18. It's half the distance to the goal. The previous play is under further review.
Automatically review targeting, so stop it all down with 6 seconds. Arizona State doesn't have to use the timeout. First and goal. Now is this targeting on Thompson.
Only rushing three gave Wilkins all the time in the world to throw this football up. But how about that? Three defenders around Darby, who's been huge all night, and he just goes up, high points the football, takes a shot to the head by Trenton Thompson, but that ball might have hit the ground, Carter.
It's clearly targeting. It's clearly targeting, but if this ball comes out and it's incomplete, then the incompletion goes in the books.
It's certainly loose. Does it hit the ground and come out? Targeting for sure. Thompson's gone.
47-yard gain if it stands. The ball and Darby going to the ground. Now the ball can touch the ground and you still maintain control of the football. So just because it touches the ground doesn't mean it's incomplete.
The ruling on the field of targeting is confirmed. Number 18 of the defense is disqualified. However, it was also determined that the pass was incomplete. It was fourth down. It will be an automatic first down at the 35-yard line for Arizona State.
For San Diego State. It's for San Diego State, and here's why you're hot if you're Arizona State. That's targeting. Targeting dislodged the football, resulting in the incomplete pass. And yet it stands. The targeting stands, no question about it, but it's an incompletion because of the hit that was targeting. It's officiated well, no question about it. But that's the end result, is Arizona State doesn't get to snap it on first and goal because of the bobble at the end of the play. that was the result of targeting. Wilkins is going to air it out. All the way to the end zone. It is batted down, incomplete, and now it's in the books. San Diego State hangs on to upset 23rd-ranked Arizona State. 28-21. The Aztecs deal the Sun Devils their first loss of the season. And the San Diego State alum, Herm Edwards, with a message of congratulations for the San Diego State head coach, Rocky Long. And San Diego State wins it 28-21. Danny Gonzalez and Rocky Long, after 17 years together, shake hands at midfield after a hard fought down to the last second. Late night thriller between the Sun Devils and the Aztecs.
Seems like a theme for this team. Aztecs defense stepping up at the end to help secure another win for the Red and Black. Thanks for watching. I'm John Schaefer. We'll see you next week on Aztec Rewind, presented by your San Diego County Toyota dealers.